there is delay by the debtor. The debtor cannot move because they don't know what to do with the board. And that causes damage to the creditors. We're not getting paid. I represent creditors, by the way. Then they can say, hey, dismiss the Title III. Obviously, it would happen sometime, not a couple of days or a couple of months, that would have to expire before that could become the case.
So the real tough question, good decision? It's not being recorded, right?
I thought that the decision was very thoughtful. I mean, it really was. I thought that grappling with the relationship between the board and the territorial government, which is an issue that has risen up many times over the course of the last 2 years in the Title III, in terms of the relative authority of each. And I also thought that it was right that even though the First Circuit found that the appointment was unconstitutional, I can't imagine what would have been the situation if the Title IIIs were dismissed, given how many things are going on in the context of those Title IIIs right now.
I want to make a little note on that. Actually, when the government of the United States, their lawyer, these are people who practice appeals all the time. That's what they do. And he got in his mind, obviously to me, that he was going to lose. And he started like getting a little bit desperate, and he asked the court, if you are going to reverse, please let us brief you on how to deal with the stay. He was adamant about that, obviously.
Yeah, several times.
Yes.
I think it was well reasoned. We'll see if the Supreme Court decides to if it gets appealed and if the Supreme Court grants cert. But it'll be interesting to see how it deals with that. But that said, I found the opinion to generally.